to that point, Dan, about proactiveness and companies needing to be proactive, that ties to culture, doesn't it? And that ties to your employee value proposition in a sense as well, as a business that's hiring, you know, competing for talent in this market. I'm wondering, when it comes to kind of philosophy, what are businesses getting wrong with their compensation philosophies? Do you see a recurring issue in your line of work? Feel free to also use examples here if it helps to illustrate it.
So the biggest thing is, I think treating, I don't know if it's coming from HR, and in many cases, I don't think it is, versus I think there's a sense of this is just how we've always done it, to a sense of there's a reason the board of directors and C-suite is telling us not to do it. But the idea of not talking about compensation far more frankly with employees to me is a huge, huge, huge miss. So at Electronic Arts, I thought they had one of the best, where it was relatively transparent because it was the first company I'd worked with where we admitted to employees that we use something called a comp ratio, which is a calculation. You know, so if I said you made $100,000, that doesn't mean anything. But if I said you made $100,000 out of 120,000, because that 120,000 is considered the mastery point, that means something. Or if the mastery point is 80,000, you make 100,000, that means something. So it measures the space you have between what a company considers a mastery point. So not only did Electronic Arts share that they did this, but they actively informed their managers and provided their managers with tools to have compensation discussions and to share things like what the mastery point was, so that employees had a good understanding of what it was they were looking for and, you know, how this all worked. Spotify was a little bit weirder in the fact they shared that we did mastery points, but they wouldn't share what the number was. And I was like, we hire machine learning engineers and data engineers. They can figure this out very, very easily. There's a reason why you hire very brilliant people. So it was this whole almost like song and dance of like, well, I can't share your comp ratio number, but it's probably between 9 and 9.5. And they'd be like, okay, so it's 0.923 because I figured this. And you're like, I can't confirm or deny it. And it's such a huge waste of time. Whereas to me, like, I found if you treat people like adults, especially employees, hey, here's this information, here's how it works, here's the science behind it, here's the methodologies we use, here's why not everyone is paid at exactly the same rate, here's why we review things at every 6 months, people are like, oh, okay, thanks, that works. Or I don't really like this answer, but I get the science and logic behind it. And so just really informing managers and empowering them to have these conversations, because I can tell you every HR business partner is so sick and tired of having to deal with compensation gone nuts in a team where everyone is sharing things on a spreadsheet and everyone's lying to each other on the spreadsheet. And then they come up to you and they're like, you know, why am I making $30,000 less? You're like, you're actually making $5,000 more. Like, he lied to you. Like, and so, like, just inform and conform and encourage this to be a far more open conversation rather than just having this behind the wall mystery thing.